Oh my God, Rigby, he's alive!
What? What are you doing here?
Let's get you back up.
Oh, what are you doing here? What's going on?
We found you here, in your chair, with what we thought was a fatal injury. We should call Swinehart, have him take a look at you.
Wait a second on that, Snow.
You know who I am?
Yes.
Good. I have a few questions.
Why? What?
Konkrety.
What's this about?
When was the last time you saw your wife, Lawrence?
I don't know. A few weeks ago. She came by to get some things. That's what she said. But I think it was so she could leave some money. I didn't find it till later. We've been separated for some time now.
Lawrence, what did you do?
I made a decision for us. It felt like the only way out. So I shot myself in the heart. Oh, thought I'd be dead by now. It hurts like fucking hell.
Your heart's actually a little more to the center. Probably had a lung.
Great. At least, that's how I think it happened. Things are a little fuzzy. Thought it was a bad dream.
Why did you do it, Lawrence?
I did it because I was ashamed. I couldn't live with myself, knowing I had done that to her. I did what I could to keep her away. But she still worries about me. She comes by, makes sure I'm okay. I'm a fucking burden. I'm useless. I don't want her to have to worry about me anymore. She's better off without me. Without me being here to drag her down. She deserves that. She's been through a lot. I just wish I could have done better by her. She's always been there for me.
Czyli...
No way. Just fucking
on jeszcze
go
nie
away.
Wie o tym.
Your wife is missing.
What? Oh, no. 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 No, no, no. I knew this would happen. Georgie!
A raczej to, co mówił, nie sugerowało, żeby zabił.
Lawrence,
Do you...
Are you expecting anyone? I'll see who it is.
No, wait. I need to know why whoever's out there is breaking in. I need your help.
What do I do?
Just play dead.
What?
Trust me. You can't move in your condition anyway, so just stay still. The second we figure out what they're here for, Bigby will arrest them. Think about your wife.
Give me back the gun, just in case.
Rozumiem, żeby dać mu chwilę, ale jednocześnie... nie przedobrzyć. No wszedł jak do siebie. Nie!
Hej! Hej! Stop! Leave me alone!
Kolego, nie poprawiasz swojej sytuacji? To nas załatwił. O tak, tu się rusza coś, więc zakładam. No pięknie. Przyznam, że na padzie te quick time eventy wcale nie są takie proste, ale rozumiem, że mamy jeszcze szansę.
Same side here.
You son of a bitch. Make me run after you. Why did you run?
What?
Why did you run?
Fuck, man. Because you chased after me. The fuck was I supposed to do? You're looking for the woodsman, right?
My employer is looking to ask him a few questions too.
No nie do końca.
Who's your employer?
I can't tell you that. It's confidential. Sorry. Sure you understand.
Nope. Can't say that I do. Come on. You're coming with me.
This could have been easy.
Oh, don't worry. It still is. Come on.
Dumb.
Dumb? Yeah, it is. Look, it'd be much easier for you
no,
to...
No, I'm D. He's dumb.
He almost looked peaceful.
Yep.
Except you're lying in a dirty alley.
Yep.
With an open wound on the back of your head.
Yep. Where'd they go?
Well, after the one guy hit you, and the other one finished kicking you...
That explains the ribs.
Then they jumped into a car and drove off. Come on, get up. We should check in on Toad, see if there's anything there that can get us back on the trail.
A mieliśmy być po tej samej stronie. Najgorzej, że czuję... Już czeka nas teraz trudna rozmowa.
And we ended up going out the window and I landed on Toad's car.
You guys made a real mess.
Yeah. Looks worse than a day.
I don't think anybody's here.
We came all this way for nothing.
All right, son. All right, he's gone. He's left. It's over now.
Tak sobie zostawili Lawrence'a. Trochę mnie to martwi, bo... Mielibyśmy pewnie jeszcze kilka pytań.
Is that his son?
Toads? I think.
Be nice in there, okay?
Czy kiedyś nie byliśmy?
Hey Toad, you in there? Bigby and Miss White. Surely you didn't come all this way just for my bother. Sorry, Bigby. It's embarrassing to have to admit, but I thought there was someone else in Woody's place.
There wasn't, though. Not when I checked. Nothing but a leaky drain pipe. Imagination must have got the best of me. So, you know, false alarm. Sorry for dragging Miss White into this, but thanks for coming. Much appreciated.
We heard someone crying.
Oh, the boy stubbed his toe on the bed frame is all. It stings, you know, but it's nothing to kick up a fuss about. A little tub swim, he'll be right as rain, I'm sure.
Is your son in there?
Oh, he's fine, Miss White. Just stung his little toe. Better swimmer than Walker, just like his dad.
Wanna...
So, I guess you'll be taking off now. No need to hang around here anymore. I mean, I'm sorry you came all the way here for nothing. But it was nothing, really.
This is for your own safety, Toad. You called us, remember?
Yeah, I know, and I appreciate it, mate, but...
It's fine. Relax. We'll be out of here in a minute. I just want to check things out first.
All right. I just don't want to waste your time, is all. Have a seat. Have a cup of tea. Whatever you like.
TJ? Are you all right? There you are. I don't mean to intrude, but Flycatcher said you had a pretty awesome insect collection, and I was wondering if you could perhaps let me see it?
It has a weevil.
Cool.
Just mind the upholstery while you're looking for nothing.
Yeah, sure thing.
No pięknie. Zacznijmy od konkretów.
How'd this happen?
Fucking hell. Damn thing must have fell off a table.
Uh-huh. The lamp just fell off the table.
Or the boy was faffing about, playing salts and swordfish. Who knows with the lad?
Ropuch, kogo chcesz oszukać? Tym bardziej, że wyrwane z gniazdka. O, a tu też coś jest nie tak.
Your lock's busted too. This place is falling apart.
Eh?
The lock. It looks like somebody kicked in the door.
For Christ's sakes, a fucking lock's been busted for weeks, mate. Right, it's just like everything else in this bloody building.
Ropuch, ja cię lubię, ale... za chwilę pogadamy. Nie wiem, czy to cię nie pogrzebało, Ropuch.
What happened here?
The poker? What of it?
There's fresh blood on the tip. I could smell it from the door.
I was poking the coals and it slipped a bit. Sliced up in my foot like a seashell. Looked like a shit ugly thing.
Sounds painful.
Oi! Don't you go mavering now. The wound didn't sit very long, you know. Perks of being a fable, I suppose. And a frog.
Skoro tak mówisz, i później skakałeś po ścianach, tak?
I've really been meaning to clean the place.
There's more blood over here.
Oh? Really?
Yeah. Still fresh?
Well, like I told you, I cut me hand. Ran around like a tit trying to pick out a rap. Must have got some on the furnishments. If you're gonna say something, out with it.
Mówiłeś o stopie.
Wait, you cut your hand? You told me before that you cut your foot.
Yeah, no, I did cut my hand. I cut my hand first, and that made me drop the damn thing on my foot. ruinous flip of events, really. Oh my god, will you not make a big faff out of this? There's nothing to solve here, Sheriff. I'm telling you everything that happened. Why don't you believe me? I mean, things happen, you know. No crime in a little accident.
I think maybe you're hiding something.
Hiding something?
Maybe. but to tell you the truth, I don't know yet. But I know you're lying about something.
But I'm not-
And you're just gonna make it worse for yourself the longer you keep up the act.
I'm not bullshitting you. Honest.
We'll see.
Pobawimy się dalej w takim razie.
What is it now? If it's blood, you know what happened.
No, there's marks here on the windowsill. And what's that about?
No real reason. Just last night, when I'd come out, I was in a downright dizzy, mate, as you would be. And I plumb forgot the keys to this place. And I had to climb in through the bloody window.
Really?
Scared Junior off to death.
Hmm.
You heard the new Shakin' Stevens album yet? Bloody hell, Bigby. What sinister bit have you uncovered this time? I left the tap water running? Didn't stop the recycling? What's the point of all this, mate? Really?
But you wouldn't need keys, since the lock's broken, so... Why'd you climb in through the window?
Huh?
Why'd you climb in through the window? You said it yourself. The lock's been rotten for weeks. You wouldn't have needed a key to get in.
Fucking hell. Just what are you on about, mate? After the state I was in, I didn't have me head, that's all it was. I forgot a fucking handle was fucking busted. And I'll tell you what else. It's embarrassing you bringing all this shit up, all right? So quit it with a third degree and all that.
Oj, żabuch, żabuch. Jeszcze coś na ciebie tu znajdziemy. Chodź, zaraz pogadamy. O! Puste pewnie. O!
There's a mark over here, too.
What you mean?
There's a clean space in the dust over here.
Oh, maybe one of Junior's toys or something? I mean, who knows?
Adam, to wygląda jak miejsce po lampce. Jak długo zostawił? Tu stała roztrzaskana lampka. No może tak.
That broken lamp used to be here, right? Just tell me what happened.
Nothing happened, mate. Nothing! And why did the lamp have to be there? Of all the blooming pointless inquiries. It's my own place. Don't you think I know what happens in it?
Zarówno gniazdko, jak i ślady.
Because it wasn't on that table, Toad. There isn't any room in the electric outlets.
Huh? What are
it
you...
It was plugged in over here, and now it's there.
I did some refiguring. Who fucking cares?
And not plug it in? Come on, Toad.
I just hadn't gotten around to it yet. You see how many damn plugs there are? Bigby, come on. I'm begging for mercy over here, old boy. I was looking forward to a nice afternoon. Just me and me son, and you've taken up enough of a day with all this... the sniffing around at me private belongings. I'm sorry I called, really I am. But will you please, please just bugger off?
Not yet.
Not yet, you say, to my face. And you think I'm hiding something from you? Well, you've had the go of the room for a fair bit of time now. Nothing's here. So when? When are you gonna leave? I mean, I feel like I'm on trial here. In my own bloody home. It's not seemly.
When? When you start telling me the truth, Toad?
Well, I've told you the truth, mate. Jesus Christ, what more do you want?
Toad? These stories have made no sense. You didn't cut yourself on the poker. You didn't forget your keys. You didn't bump the lamp off the table. You want to tell me what's going on?
She doesn't think much of me, I don't think.
Oh, I wouldn't necessarily say that. Progress? Mr. Toad, you're bleeding.
Take off the hat.
It was that butcher, a Tweedle, Dumb or D,
You gotta strip them down to their johnnies before you can tell which is which. They come bulging in, screaming about something the woodsman had. Or thought he had, I don't know. He tore up the place, beat me up when I said I didn't have it. And if you had come in when I asked you to, maybe he wouldn't have the nerve to strong-arm me boy.
He hurt Toad Jr. How awful.
What the hell does he care? It's always the same with you, isn't it, Bigby? If I'm in trouble, need help, if I call about something, you always take live long day to get here. What if he'd done something worse, eh? I'm tired of feeling trivial, mate. A lot of us are.
We're sorry, TJ. Really.
What did you tell him?
Nothing. There's nothing he wanted to know, except if I had this thing that he wanted. I would have told you. I wanted to, really, I did. But he said if word of this ever got back to him, if he ever thought you knew, or Miss White, he'd come back and kill my boy. I even tried to give the bastard a coat. He wouldn't take it.
Whose coat?
The girl.
Dad borrows things from people who live here. Sometimes.
Borrows?
I don't steal nothing. Turn around here would astonish you, mate. I merely repossess what's been left behind.
Well, we'll be taking the coat now. If she has next of kin, family, anyone.
All right. Fetch him the fur. Fine bit of dress it is.
Jak rozumiem, to te zasła.
No, I wouldn't wear it outside. Wait. It's an envelope. Fucking hell, of course there is. For my luck, it's a map to some bloody doubloons.
It's addressed to Prince Lawrence. What do you want to do with it?
Don't make it a dilemma.
No chyba dla dobra dochodzenia. Nie wiem, czy powinniśmy, ale...
I'm sorry, Faith.
What could she have been sorry for?
I don't know. But maybe Lawrence does.
Well, it's been quite a surprising day for all of us, hasn't it? I'd see you out, but I'm afraid of dripping any more blood in the place.
It was very nice talking to you, TJ.
Thanks. See ya.
And don't worry about what happened earlier. Just feel better, okay?
And if you're looking for the woodsman, try it down at the Trip Trap.
Does it always go that smoothly?
Not often.
So, split a cab?
Sure. I can only go to the Trip Trap for now, anyway.
Not because of what Toad said.
Hopefully the woodsman's there. Or, I don't know, someone who will know where to find him. It's my best lead.
Our only lead, really.
When you put it that way.
To był ciężki dzień. Ale w kolejnej części spotkamy się już w następnym odcinku. A teraz na koniec jeszcze księga baśni do nadrobienia. Nasza koleżanka nie doszła. Nie doszła do naszego domu, tak? Jaśmin, znana również jako księżniczka w oślej skórze, przetrwała eksodus z niczym prócz ubrań, które miała na sobie, mężem i ocalonym życiem. Była kiedyś piękną księżniczką, żyjącą w szczęśliwym związku małżeńskim z księciem Laurensem z sąsiadującego królestwa. Powinna żyć długo i szczęśliwie, ale doczesny Nowy Jork nie oszczędził jej ani jej małżeństwa. Z powodu braku pieniędzy zajęła się prostytucją, by zarobić na czynsz za tanie mieszkanie na obrzeżach Baśniogrodu. Miała trudne życie, ale zrobiła co mogła, by przetrwać w nieprzyjaznym świecie. No dobrze, kolega, którego nie lubimy za bardzo. Crane, pochodzący z nawiedzonej sennej kotliny. Ich bot, Crane, od prawie 115 lat jest zastępcą burmistrza Baśniogrodu. to istny kłębek nerwów i bardzo poważnie traktuje swoją pracę, co nie znaczy, że zawsze dobrze ją wykonuje. Jako przedstawiciel baśniogrodzkiej elity jest często ślepy na potrzeby mniej zamożnych mieszkańców. Jest autorytatywnym tchórzem, wiecznie mającym coś do ukrycia. Kolega z jego biura, Bawkin. Bawkin jest gadającą skrzydlatą małpą z krainy Oz. Teraz, jako bibliotekarz baśniogrodu, spędza czas na czytaniu i podkradaniu trunków zastępcy burmistrza. Lubi płatać figle, więc gdy tylko coś pójdzie nie tak, zakłada, że wina spadnie na niego. Gdy chce, potrafi być pomocny, ale zazwyczaj woli pociągnąć z butelki. Już dawno by go zwolniono, ale jest jedynym, który rozumie tamtejszy system archiwizacji. To się urządził Bawkin. Sympatyczny jegomość. O, a to co to za ekipa? Niebaśniowce. Doczesne to termin, którym baśniowcy określają niemagicznych mieszkańców swojego przybranego domu. Zaklęcia ochronne nałożone na baśniogród i farmę sprawiają, że w pewnych granicach umysły doczesnych są rozkojarzone, a ich zmysły przytępione. Jeśli jednak cokolwiek wzbudziłoby ciekawość dużej grupy doczesnych, nastąpiłoby przeciążenie zabezpieczających czarów i przestałyby one działać. Jednym z głównych zadań Bigby'ego jako szeryfa baśniogrodu jest zapewnienie, że społeczność nie przyciągnie niechcianej uwagi. Okej. O nasz książę. Po ucieczce z rodzinnych stron książę Lawrence i jego żona Jaśmin natychmiast padli ofiarą okrutnej rzeczywistości doczesnego świata. Przeprowadzili się do Nowego Jorku, licząc na pomoc ze strony innych baśniowców. Niestety nie było ich stać na zamieszkanie w samym baśniogrodzie, więc nie docierało do nich niewielkie wsparcie, na jakie mogli mieć nadzieję. Ich widoki na przyszłość były coraz gorsze. Jaśmin zostawiła więc męża i starała się poradzić sobie sama. Teraz, bez wsparcia ze strony żony, Lawrence nie może znaleźć w sobie motywacji i szybko popada w depresję. A także bliźniacy, najęte zbiry. Bracia Deludi i Deludam są zbirami do wynajęcia. Wyglądają jak ludzie, co pozwala im wykonywać zlecenia w doczesnym świecie bez wzbudzania podejrzeń. Są równie nierozłączni jak bezwzględni. No i to by było chyba na tyle, jeżeli chodzi o nowości w poznanym tu świecie. Z tego co widzę na liście, powoli zbliżamy się też do finału pierwszego epizodu, ale przed nami kilka kolejnych, więc bez obaw. Choć przyznam, że z każdym odcinkiem ta historia coraz bardziej wciąga i nie mogę się doczekać już tego, co wydarzy się dalej, ale na to już zapraszam w naszym kolejnym spotkaniu. A tymczasem dzięki za to, że jesteście, dzięki za to, że gramy razem. Grał z wami Korle, trzymajcie się. Hej, hej.